Hello everyone. In today's session, we will continue from our last fixed asset concepts, then fixed asset acquisition, which we have performed in our last session. And I would like to also show the fixed asset which we have acquired through purchasing process in our last session. This is the fixed asset computer number 9. And you can as well see the books which are now linked with the fixed asset. And there are four kind of books, and the books are in order to calculate the financial life of a fixed asset, and that can have a different fiscal periods or different service life periods or depreciation periods, you can say. So each one will have a different life. This is for reporting purpose, as was previously mentioned. So we can see here that the calculate depreciation is selected as no. So if you at this stage create a depreciation proposal or create a depreciation, so it won't allow you to create a depreciation because the calculate depreciation checkbox is selected as no. So what I will need to do is for this fixed asset, I will select SLSL, which is state line service life. I will turn the calculate depreciation as yes, and will save it and close it. So the next step is very simple. Either you can go through this create depreciation proposal option, or you can go to the fixed asset journal, and then create a journal, and within that journal there is a proposal option, which I will first of all I will just use this option, create depreciation proposal, and there will be a dialog box in which you can select the filter criteria on which you need to depreciate the fixed asset. So due date is important factor here, because the due date is as of you want to depreciate the fixed asset. A specific fixed asset, you can enter a fixed asset group or a book. So for specific, you need to go to this lookup and select any specific fixed asset. That is, I will just this is computer 9 with the this fixed asset code, and there is a date like 30th June 2022. Because the fixed asset, this one was acquired on 3rd of January 2022. So I will like to just end the depreciation till the last date of fiscal year. So different countries, they have different fiscal year. For example, some countries like in KSA, they have 1st January to 31st December as a fiscal year. But in Pakistan, India or other countries, they have 1st of July till 30th June next year. So for this fiscal year, I would like to post the depreciation expenses. So that's why I am selecting two date for as 30th June to 2022. Another important option is like posting layers in which your books already exist. So in this case, it will be current. And then name of journal, fixed asset entries, current. So journals need to exist in GL module, which I will just show you. If you go to the GL module here, in the collapse everything, and then go to journal setup and go to journal names. Here you will find this fixed asset entries, current. And you will have to have a separate number sequence for this, and journal type need to be post fixed asset. So apart from this, posting layer need to be current, which will belong to this journal exactly. And if you see, there are other journals as well, and they can have a different posting layer, or posting layer as none, or posting layer can be text posting layer. So there can be different posting layers on which you will be posting the financials. So this is where you need to see whether the journal already exists. So this will be also a filter criteria, and there is an important option, summarize depreciation. So what it will do, either you need to create a single entry for all the depreciation from 3rd of January till 30th June, only a single line, or you would like to have a different line for each of the month. Month can be a calendar month or a fiscal month as you have selected in your setup earlier on. So if I do not select summarized depreciation, so there will be 6 entries, because from January, February, March, then April, May and June. So there will be 6 entries, and based upon when the fixed asset was acquired. So that will have equal depreciation amounts except the first month, because first month 2 days are lacking, 1st and 2nd January, because this asset was acquired on 3rd of January. So the amount of first month will be lesser, and then from February onwards it will be equal amounts. There can be other filter criteria if you would like to only depreciate based upon a fixed asset group instead of an asset. So you will remove this fixed asset specific number and you will mention a fixed asset group from this lookup. And if you don't want to select from it and you want to select per book level, per book basis, so you can select any of the book and remove all other options, so that specific book will be depreciated. Okay, so then there is another option of batch processing in order to for you if there is a very long list of a fixed asset, so you would not like to wait for this, rather you will assign the task to the server. So for that purpose, batch processing can be enabled. For now, it is only single asset, so I will not turn it on. So that's it. I will just go ahead and create, select the button create journal. As soon as I select this option, so depreciation proposal will be created and the message will be shown that a journal number 630 was created. I will go to the fixed asset module and go to fixed asset journal here in journal entries group. You can see the number which was shown 630, there is a journal header created, and you can go to the lines level. And you can see here 6 lines have been created for each of the month, end of the each of the month, which was earlier on selected in the setup. So the credit amount, this credit goes to the asset account. So earlier on when you acquired the asset, it was debited, and now the asset will be credited. So there will be 2 accounts which will be hit in this case. There is one accumulated depreciation account, which is a balance sheet account, and the other one is depreciation account, which is an expense or P&L account. So there will be the effect on the 2 accounts. So here you can see this is depreciation account, depreciation expense, starting with number 6. This is depreciation expense account. So the debit entry will go to the offset account, which is the expense account. The expense will be debited with this amount. So you can see here, if the asset's total amount was 1000 USD on which it was acquired, so if you divide the total life, which was 60 period or 5 years, 60 periods means 60 months, so this will be the equal amount of depreciation per month. So you can see here, February onwards till 30th of June, 16.67 USD amount is being depreciated except the first month. First month, why 15.59? That is very simple, because the setup was done on the calendar year instead of the fiscal year. So what we need to do, because in January there are 31 days. So this amount of depreciation per month need to be divided by 31 days in order to get per day depreciation amount, and then you will multiply this amount with 29 days, because there are 2 days less from January, because the acquisition date is 3rd of January. So I will multiply this with 29 days in order to get the same amount for January, 15.59. So I think this is very clear. Since January has 31 days, so we need to less 2 days in order to get the accurate amount of depreciation for January onwards. And then this journal need to be posted. There is another option which I will just show you before posting this. If you go to the fixed asset journal, and here you can also directly create a journal if you don't want to create through proposal from outside, although it is easier option. You can create a journal here, go to the lines area, and here you can see the proposal option is given. Here also you can select this depreciation proposal option, and the same dialog box will be shown. And here if you enter the same 30th June 2022 and all other filter criteria by clicking this filter and selecting any of the values, as we have seen in previous example, there is a lookup here. Similarly, you can pick any of the value. So we will be creating again the same journal for the same fixed asset here. Okay, so posting layer is current, all other options are same, and the status of asset should not be closed, scrapped, or not yet acquired. Okay, so I will press OK and it will give me the same results you can see here. Okay, so another option I would also like you to see it is summary depreciation. So the same procedure, you go to the proposal from here or from outside menu item, and you can just select this summarize depreciation, and the remaining criteria is same. So now only single line will be shown with the total depreciation amount as a single entry. So there is a default description which is also created for us, that depreciation since 31st of January 2022, although it is from the acquisition date, not from this date. So this will be a single entry shown here instead of a period wise entry. So it is up to you. If you have so many assets, so you won't like to create each entry for month, but if you want to also check the system whether the calculations, which are definitely correct, in order to tally with your own calculations, so the option of period wise depreciation is always available. So now I will delete the newest journal and the previous journal which we have created from outside menu item. I will just validate it. And before this, we can also check the report which I have shown earlier on as well, fixed asset balances report. And I will put the criteria of the same fixed asset code. So validation has been successful. This need to be just posted now. Before that, I just need to call the report in order to see the basically current status of the asset and after posting the depreciation. For that purpose, I will just put a filter here, which is already there. Here also you can select a lookup. From the lookup, you can pick up the asset, specific asset, so that report only contains the data related with this asset. There are multiple other reports as well from you, where you can see the data, like acquisition. There was an acquisition report as well, and there was an inquiry form for fixed asset transaction, from where you can see whatever is happening against that asset. So that is here, fixed asset transaction. Okay, and here I can put a fixed asset number here. Number begins with comp, and then I will put a contents criteria here, and I will say that okay, starting with comp and any value, and then ending with 9 value. So related with this asset, all transactions are shown, which are now only acquisition transactions. And if you can see the balance report here, so we are basically depreciation on this book SLSL. So right now there is no value in the depreciation. So I will just post this journal, the depreciation journal. So the journal is now posted, and the posted option is shown as a ticked option. I can refresh here. you can see the depreciation entries have been posted separately here with a separate voucher as well. And if now I again call this fixed asset balances report, it will show me the depreciation amount for the asset. And then it will deduct basically the depreciation amount. You can see here the accumulated depreciation is basically then deducted from the acquisition amount in order to show us the net book value of $901.06. So this is how you need to perform the depreciation against the assets. If it is on based on fixed asset group or book or any specific asset that need to be selected in depreciation proposal options. Or you can also create a manual entry. It depends upon you if system is giving you a flexibility. So you would rather use this depreciation proposal option. Okay. Apart from this, you already need to be done basically with the depreciation fixed asset posting profiles, which I have earlier on shown as well, that depreciation account need to be already set up here. So this is very important step, and in here you can see the books are basically connected with the accounts here, which are basically accumulated depreciation, that is a balance sheet account, and then P&L account of depreciation expense. So on book level, or you can put a fixed asset to directly to main account level, or you can put a fixed asset group to the main account. It depends upon your accounting procedures, policies and procedures, how you want to basically perform this depreciation based upon whatever level it is. So I am hopeful this would be an informative session. If you have any queries or anything else you need to basically ask, please comment on the video. Thank you very much, and stay tuned for my next video.